Hello everybody, and welcome to a new quick tutorial. I'm going to dive right into what the title says, because many people just want to have a quick tutorial on how to make bound armor of blood magic. I'm sorry. Most of you know what you need. I will tell you, and you need this thing. Soul Armor Forge. Oh, not that. You also need, I forgot, you also need to have some filled sockets. That goes here. Those are crafted like this. You can also look it up if you have the newest version, I think, of Blood Magic. In 1.7.2 is this. Add a Mexican blood orb. Excuse me for my pronouncements. And the gold block and some life points. Yeah, they are called life points. You need one of this, and you need about 25 of these if you want to make one set of armor. If you want to, I will explain it later. You just need 25. Well, you need 25 of these. Those are I already showed it, and those are quite expensive, 30,000. But in the end, it's all worth me. It's all worth it. Trust me. You're basically done. You can do it with this. But of course, you want to have some cool upgrades. Excuse me. In the beginning, you will want to start with some weak blood shards. Weak blood shards. But if you are like higher end at some point, you maybe want to use the demon blood shards. I will cover these in a later episode, how to get these. Or you can Google it and find it. Another thing I might suggest is using master blood orbs. I will explain that also in a bit, but I suggest getting 4. These are crafted like this. Use a weak blood shard. Excuse me again, I have a bit of sore throat. And use 40,000 life points. Well, as I said, you can upgrade the armor. You can also just craft it like how to make them? It's not like in a crafting grid, like making them like this. No, you need to do it a little bit. Why can't I? Never mind. You need to do it like that, but then in the real world, you can do it like horizontal. This is vertical, or you can do it horizontal, and it both works. When you have done this, you right click on this block with an empty hand. You have a nice sound effect, and to prove it also work with this. Okay, now you have crafted a bound helmet. But as you see, this is just a regular old boring bound helmet, and I don't like boring stuff, so I'm going to throw them away. What you want to do is get yourself some sigils. I've listed them here, what they do. I don't know what the original name is. I know this is water and this is lava, but the water one gives you water breathing. The lava gives you the lava thing. The lava sigil gives you fire resist. This is a fight sigil. This gives you no fight fog, which is really nice if you are recording, and no void damage. That means if you like fly under the bedrock, I have no idea why you don't take any damage if you fly too low. I don't know how that happens when you go like too deep. Oh, I'm sorry. But we can test that in a bit. This one prevents fall damage. That's air sigil. Really nice. This one is haste like mining haste. It's I think always active when you're mining, only it's always active, so it will drain all your life points if you don't watch out. You have a this couldn't fit all on it, but the speed sigil or something that lets you run faster. It gives you speed boost and jump as a jump boost and a block assist or something like that. Let me FTB armor creation. Let me search it so I can like I don't lie to you because I don't really want to. Okay, I have the list. This is the, let me look, there's a whole list. Sigil of Haste. It basically makes you run faster and stuff, but here it gives you, it does the same but then on your armor. This is the Sigil, Divination Sigil. It gives you Night Vision. This is the, let me see, the Sigil of the Green Grove. It makes plants grow faster, like the Sigil does in its, on its own. This is the Sigil of the Whirlwind. I'm sorry, my English pronouncement isn't the best, but it basically deflects arrows, which is really nice when you know where you're going to deal a lot with arrows. This is the Sigil of the Phantom Bridge. It basically creates a Phantom Bridge if you are wearing it. I'm not used to being creative. And this is the Sigil of Magnetism, I think. Yes, it is. And it picks up blocks, like the item says, within 10 blocks. Pick up items within 10 blocks. Okay, now we are going to create actual armor. I'm going to create my favorite set of armor. Did I do this right? No, I didn't. Okay, drop that away. I'm going to make them horizontal because that's the way I like it. It's quite easy. I'm going to create here my chest piece. Here, it's not. I don't like when they are touching each other. Stop touching each other. Okay, let's drop these down, and I need a 2 boots. Okay. Well, 1 boots, but oh, no, I need those. Well, doesn't need them anymore. You can choose the difference between using a weak blood shard and demon blood shark is basically... Why is it getting darker? Never mind. The difference is basically the weak blood shard, you can add 1 sigil per piece of armor. And the demon, you can add like 2 sigil upgrades to a piece of armor. Really handy. I'm going to apply 2 of them because I have them. You can apply them anywhere you want. Just place them anywhere. After that, the reason why you want to add a master blood orb to each piece of armor, I know it's getting really expensive due to life points and other stuff. But some sigils, like the Sigil of Haste, or the Sigil of Basic Movement, or the Sigil of Fire Resistance and Water Breathing, does constantly drain your life points. And that's a thing you don't want to happen. Because, well, early game not, because life points are quite valuable then. If you add these, like, the water breathing doesn't drain any life points. And the haze doesn't... I think I have it play... I've played with the haze one on, like, single play... on multiplayer. And it doesn't drain at all. I don't know why, but it doesn't drain, so meh. I'm happy. Now I'm going to apply some sigils. I'm going to apply a water breathing on the helmet because Aqua Affinity. And Void because it's also like sea thing. I'm going to apply Haste. And what's the thing that negates fall damage? This one. On the boots. On the boots, yes. Do note, as you may saw in a moment ago, I already placed, I think, a magical block, a magician block, blood orb in this one, and demon blood shard and a sigil in this one. And the only spot I can put one in is here, so don't get confused and don't be like, oh no, I can't make it. You can make it, but you know. I'm going to add fire resist in the chest piece and already add haste. I don't know. I think I put haste in the wrong boots. Give me a second. I will leave you the video. Okay, welcome back. I just saw in the footage I added haste to my thing because I constantly think in my brain haste is like the mining thing. I actually wanted to add jump assist. It doesn't really matter where you put them because it's all over the body, but I like to put them in a logical order. So I'm going to put jump assist in the leggings. And Did I already add night vision? No, I didn't. I'm going to add, I'm just going to add everything, arrows thing and like the chest piece. I don't know if I already added one something there, but I will see it pretty quick. A phantom bridge, why not? I think I've added everything in the chest pieces and stuff like that. Yeah. I don't know, I just put them in. It will negate if you put too many in. Now I'm going to... Oh, goddammit, no. Now I'm going to make the creation of them. Okay. Oh, yeah, I derped here. Okay. Let's see, did I did it right? No, I... Oh. Okay, let me make the chest piece again. I kind of failed at it. Okay, I didn't fail at it. I put them in some places where they couldn't be added in. So I failed at that. So I picked up one demon blood shard and one orb. Let's see what I have put in here. Fire resistance, and I'm going to put item pickup thingy because that's easy to test. Okay, that, and what's the other thing? Fire resist, because I really love that one. It's kind of powered, but meh. Bam! Oh, yeah. Okay, now it's completely done. Yes, they are all amazingly. I'm going to throw that one away, because that one is useless. So, basically, you can use one, because these aren't getting used up, so you can use one, but for demonstration purposes, I used more. Let's unequip everything and throw it away, because it uses old crap. Make use of the benefits of it, you need to put it on, but if you put it on like this, it doesn't do anything. You see, I have water breathing. But if I'm in survival, let's just put it on. If I'm here in survival and I have everything on me, like the Phantom Bridge, I don't know if I'm going to... Nope, I'm not going to like that one. There's a way to get rid of it. Oh, wait, where did I put the Phantom Bridge in? In my helmet? Or in my leggings? Oh, it spawns a Phantom Bridge wherever you are. So if you put it in your... Okay, do not, people, don't put a Phantom Bridge not where you don't want it. Don't use it Phantom Bridge at all, please. Okay, let's go down. Hop. Okay. Anyway, let's hop into survival. And let's use that. It's kind of annoying. Excuse me for this. But you see it's now being used and the Phantom Bridge aren't disappearing. That's also a bug. I think I'm going to report it after this. Basically what you're doing, Oh, I'm going to die. Oh, no. Oh, yeah, I forgot. This is going to protect me. Normally, I think it's a bug, but you need to bound it to yourself by, like, right-clicking it. So, this. Yeah, that's no. Give me a second. I'm going to recraft the boots. Okay, I'm back. I recrafted the boots. I made it more different. This should disappear normally, but it doesn't. I don't know why, but meh. Who cares at the moment? You see, I have all these things and all these amazingly buffs. Let's see. I can now, I don't get fall damage, and I can like, oh, if I get in survival, can like stay on the water, I think, mm-hmm. for a long time. Yeah, look, even the things aren't going to, aren't going down, the breathing symbols. Jump assist, step assist, everything you actually want on a piece of armor, it's amazing. One thing do note, you're basically on people, things can't kill you, so let me hop in creative for a second. Let me spawn, excuse me, that was my phone if you were able to hear it. Creeper, let's spawn some creepers. Let's hop back in survival and see, it doesn't even hurt me. So awesome is it. Do note, let's hop back quick and creative and let's get an orb. orb, the creative one. And let's get the sigil. It does drain life points when I hop back in survival. So you see now I have like that amount of life points. I'm not going to speak that out, but if I get damage or anything, I will lose some. Do note, I don't have anything now in my inventory. I should take damage. I don't know. I think it's supposed to be when you're. Strange. Anyway, normally when it when you don't take any drowning damage, when you use up the life points, for example. Did I already test a bit of creep again? Yes. See. It basically instantly drains your life points, and that's the thing you don't want to happen. Let's see, whether you have to. I think that was it for now. I think you understand anything. If you have any questions, ask them down below. I will try to answer them all. I think this is my hill. Yes, this is. No, this is not my hill, but I will find it. I hope you find this thing useful and. Yeah, if you like the video, if it helps you, give it a like. If you think some friend has some trouble with the blood magic bound armor, send him to this video. I'm gladly to help him out. If this video doesn't help him, I will help him in the video description. I will see you guys next time. Bye bye.